Neuro intestino, insomnia and hypersomnia. Insomnia occurs more than 3 times per week in the last month, and the symptoms are the overall decrease in the sleep, and so the patient feels extremely fatigued with a lot of yawning and a little bit anxious. Is a little bit more common in women than in men, and present in 30% of the population. Insomnia could be associated with many disorders, as part of the major depressive disorder or as part of other neurological and psychiatric disorders. But we need to exclude other causes in order to treat exactly just the insomnia. So once we have excluded everything, then and the patient has insomnia that could not be explained by other issue, so the treatment would be a hygiene management of the sleep. This includes only modification of the a little bit of the sleep and of the food. These modifications are avoidance of caffeine before sleep, avoidance of taking naps in the day, schedule a sleep time, and so try to sleep at the same time and awake at the same time. Next, only use the bed for sleep and not to eat or to watch TV, nor to read, etc. Only for sleep. Try not to eat a lot in the night and schedule food time. If the patient has not responded to this management, then we can try some pharmacologic treatment for less than 2 weeks. This would include the newest benzodiazepines or similar to them, that are zolpidem, zaleplon, escitalopram, and benzodiazepines sometimes, very rarely, and difenhidramine, that is an antihistamine medication of first generation that has sedative effects. Now for hypersomnia is the opposite. The patient overall sleeps more. This should have passed in the last month, and this increase in sleep cannot be explained by other causes, any other causes, so it's a diagnostic of exclusion. And the treatment that the doctors give are stimulants in order that the patient not be sleeping, and sometimes is arise. So now in the next video, we will see narcolepsy.